South Florida. Obviously, I'm sure everybody has seen that Russians are buying up the beach. They're all living in anywhere from Miami Beach to heavily populated Sun Isles, all the way up to Boca. And the real estate market is booming. Russians are moving here. There's a lot of Russians who are tourists, but they also are moving here full time. So, and I think that's continuing to steadily increase through the years.
Why Miami?
Russians love tropical climate. Russians love to live on the beach. Russians love high rises. So it's very, very, very popular. So if a lot of Russians are here, mostly moving to Brooklyn or New York, but they move down here. They absolutely love the beach. And as you can see, not only are they living on the beach, but even the stores, if you take a look and all the Sun Isles, it's like you almost feel like you're in Russia or Ukraine, because all the businesses, if you look at the lettering, they're all Russian. So one business after another, it's Russian. So it's really incredible.
I was
going to
say, this is a fusion. Why not anywhere else?
Well, why Sun Isles? I don't know. First of all, it's beautiful. And so, yes, absolutely. Sun Isles is very interesting because I think it's maybe a lot of the buildings there are more new than Fort Lauderdale. Fort Lauderdale is a very historical city, and they're actually starting to build it up now. They're tearing down a lot and they're rebuilding, so a lot of them are more modern, unique, and new. But I think Russians love that new construction. They love all the glass windows and they love being on the beach. So I think maybe they started in Sun Isles, but I think as more condominiums are built that are new, and there's some amazing designs by amazing builders, and I think that if they continue to build in Fort Lauderdale, Boca, I think the Russians will be there, because I mean there's only a certain amount of real estate. Once it's gone, Russians need to go somewhere. So if it's going to be up north, they'll go up north. If it needs to be down south, they'll go down south. But they love the climate.
Forgive me if I got this wrong, but we don't hear about anyone else but the wealthy Russians. Is it only really the wealthy Russians that are coming here, or is there still a middle class Russian?
There's absolutely a middle class.
Different ethnic groups. I think that
but I just don't think that that has ever died. And I think that that is probably one of the reasons that you hear such negativity. And also, people want to hear about that. Like, people don't want to hear about something that's good, and people obviously don't want to hear about everything is great, and they're moving here, and they're contributing to real estate taxes and paying taxes like everybody else. So that's not exciting. The exciting is the juicy stuff.
I remember a while back I didn't hear about Washington being going to have babies or not. It was sort of some people saying, okay, I can understand why it works. That's kind of overall economics. Is that okay? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. From South Florida, people who live here, how should they feel about this? See and hear about this influx, this Sunny Isles invasion, per se. How should we feel about that?
Well, I don't know that it's different than how they should feel about any other group. I think that there was a time when humans were first moving here. And now, and perhaps there was a time when humans were not as accepted as they are today. They are very important. South Florida and very valued in South Florida as a whole, the whole community. But I think at one point they started somewhere, and I think that that's very similar to what's happening with the Russian
invasion. What is fueling this Russian invasion? What is telling people to come now?
There's obviously Russia, Ukraine.
So
there's a lot of things going on.
The next Friday.
There's definitely a lot more opportunities here. People see it as opportunity for themselves, for their families. It's a great place to live. I'm talking about the U.S. and why South Florida. I think before people were concentrating on moving to New York and Brooklyn, and that was the thing to do. And there's a lot of Russians who live there. But a lot of them are moving here. I think that Florida, because of the climate, because how beautiful it is on the beach, and because they love high rises, I think it's a venue that is going to continue to grow.
Venezuela and Brazilians,
yes,
are known for buying up property and never living, basically farming. Are Russians doing the same
thing? I think that they do buy investments. I also think they buy properties that they use maybe as a second home, and they're traveling a lot because there are a lot of Russians who are here
part-time.
There's a huge Russian population of people who are here full-time, but a lot of them are here part-time. Somewhere around that area, and then they'll just travel back and forth. So, I'm not really sure.
Who are these folks? Who are they?
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes. Yes.
Who are these folks? What kind of people are they? What kind of Russians are they? Brokers, bankers?
They are brokers. They are bankers. There are a lot of Russian real estate agents. There are lawyers. There are a lot of doctors. There are business professionals, just such as yourself and myself, and they're everyday people who are business professionals and who are looking to better themselves, and the reason they came here is for opportunities.
Russian personality is really
good. Yes, it depends. They're not all the same.
No,
but yes.
For sure. She is a whole the most outgoing person I've ever met. I've also seen a Russian that are completely opposite.
Yes.
Explain to me, what? Because obviously there's a culture.
I think it depends on who it is. And it may also have a lot to do with age. And I believe a significant part of that mix would be how long they've lived here. I personally have lived in the U.S. for 35 years, so as you can hear, I don't have a Russian accent, but I speak fluent Russian, and I'm very Americanized. But I wouldn't maybe put myself in the same category as someone who maybe just moved here a year ago. because we would be on different levels. They're still learning about the American culture. They're still adapting to our community down here, whereas I had an opportunity. So I think when you see some Russians that maybe are not as outgoing and they just are very to them, correct, sheltered, maybe keep to themselves, not really sure, not with a smile on their face, it's probably because they're not accustomed to their surroundings or maybe just trying to gather their bearings.
These cultures are very different.
Yes, very different. It is. We need a couple hours for that. It's very different cultures, and again, it's very difficult to stereotype because I don't think that all Russians are created equal, just like all Americans are not created equal, Hispanics and the like. It's very, very hard to answer that question.
It seems like there's a lot of adjustment on both sides. From the American side, it's like kind of like less enough, but on, but more. Why perhaps this place, New York, established and grew this community source of view is really, we have to hear that flourishing.
Yes.
Interesting, okay. Awesome. So it's great to hear about the most expensive penthouse ever purchased. So it just happened. Fisher Island.
Yes.
Twice.
I think like 90% of Fisher Island is actually
owned by Russians. You think so?
Yes, I'm pretty
sure. You represent a few of those?
I actually don't represent real estate clients. Okay. My law firm specializes in first country.
He bought, I think it was somewhere in the neighborhood of almost $40 million. Twice when we've ever paid for a penthouse official. It's not even built yet. So he hasn't seen it. What do you think about that? That it wasn't a Brazilian, it wasn't a Venezuelan, or South American, it was a Russian buyer that came in here. What does it say to you?
It says to me that Russians are an affluent community, and I have personal knowledge that I know that the majority of Fisher Island are Russian. So just like Sunny Isles is a growing Russian population, the same thing with Fisher Island. So, and it's a different type of environment. It's beautiful. And if you're looking for something that luxurious and you're looking for more space other than something that's a condominium, it doesn't surprise me.
Does the protections matter over there? I think the security is an issue. You're talking about security is an issue back home in Russia. Security is just different.
It certainly can. It is. I wouldn't say that I have too much knowledge about that, so I don't think I could speak to that intelligently because I'm really not sure.
What's the point of doing something like this? Make sure that very business owners. What are you trying to get?
Well, Russian American Chamber is an incredible organization. We're going on 6 years. We have business networking events such as this anywhere from 1 to 3 times per month. The idea is to bring local businesses together who have a common thread in the Russian community and to bring meaning to the Russian community through businesses. And in the same realm, also build a bridge between the Russian American communities. Russians feel it's very, very important for them to have a good relationship with Americans, and Americans absolutely love coming to our events because they want to get their foot in the door into the Russian market. So it's a win-win situation, and it's a great opportunity for people to grow their business and develop relationships to, you know, build their practice, attract clients.
Before this, there was a feeling that the Russian community wasn't really branching out.
There definitely, before Russian American Chamber, I would say that there was really no unity within the Russian community. There was not a network that would bring the Russian community together. And not only through business networking events, but through community events. We do a lot of community outreach. We do a lot of events for women, for children, for elderly. So we are bringing a community together, not only through business, but through different things. And just from my personal knowledge and being very involved in the organization, there's people who not only have developed business relationships and built their book of business and referral base, but they've developed personal friendships that they never had before. And I think a lot of people who participate in Russian American Chamber had no idea that there are so many Russian businesses, or even knew of so many Russian people, you know, who live in South Florida. So I think on many different levels, on social, family, business, I think it's a great opportunity for people.
Yeah,
I'll do it. Get along. Fantastic. Thank you.